So I am making this video for all my friends, family members who are probably looking back over the last couple of days if they have, which they probably haven't. But if they've noticed what I've done, they're probably thinking, "Chris, what the fuck, dude?" And I understand that. Believe me, I do. But you have to understand me. And if you understand me well, and those are my friends who do understand me well, they already saw that coming. They knew that was going to happen. They already knew that that psychology, that thing had descended upon me, that being, that awareness, that sense of myself had come into play. And I'm sorry, you know, what can I do? Once upon a time, I was a little kid and I was raised by people who gave me overdoses of Jesus Christ every day. I mean, I had to get up at 6 o'clock in the morning and fucking read scriptures for an hour before I went to school. I used to tell people when I was a teenager, you know, sex, drugs, rock and roll, even though I hadn't had sex and I only tried to smoke weed, and I liked a lot of rock and roll, you know, and other things. Rap music, Cypress Hill was the Black Sunday album that really was the turning point, the 20 Packs of Hemp inside. And, you know, there wasn't the turning point. There was no turning point. I came out like that. I was never into their descriptions of it. I see that thing as a rebel. I see that thing as something that's prepared to challenge everything for what is right and what is holy. And so I came into this twisted Mormon reality that I believe I helped create. And I had the awareness of myself as this thing from the very beginning, because I inserted myself into my mother. I didn't really wake up to it until December 19th, 1999. That is when it came in. I left my brother's house. We were fighting. I was 21 years old, maybe something like that. 20, yeah, 20, 21 years old. I had my two best friends with me, and we were driving away from my Mormon brother in Murrieta's house, and he said to him, you know, my friend said to me, "Man, we're the new prophets, man. We're the real prophets. We're the ones who really know what's going on." That's, you know, I mean, it's another story entirely. And then somebody said it. I don't know who said it, but it got said. It came up for the first time. "Oh shit, Chris, you could be a prophet. Shit, you look like Jesus. You could be Jesus, dude." And in that moment, a virus entered my awareness that really it hatched outside of my own heart, my own spirit, my own chakras, you know, my own energy, everything that came with me as a space traveler into this world. The thing unlocked inside of me, and suddenly I had, you know, a 72, 80-hour vision of everything. First, it unfolded with how that personality, that character, needed to be born into this world, and that I was going to be the vessel for it. And whether I wanted to be or not to be, it wouldn't matter, because if it was going to be, it was going to be, and if it was not going to be, it was not going to be. And after that happened to me, a understanding unfolded, a memory, a past life download, if you will, of what it was like to be him, what it was like to go through all of that, and everything he understood and read meant, wanted to see happen. Just the full understanding of his will, the full understanding of his mind, as if it were not yours but mine. And I got to see everything else too. After that, everything else came in. Krishna, Shiva, Brahma, Allah, the awareness of all of it. And I am not Allah, and I do not see myself as Allah or Brahma, but I am the incarnation of man. And that's what I've been preparing myself for my whole life, you know, to take this mystical journey to this boundary. When I left Christianity behind with the way already, I mean, I was into Taoism since I was like 5 years old. Basically, as soon as I saw Yin Yang for the first time, Tai Chi, I knew that that was the truth, that that is the supreme symbol of the universe, that that is the way everything works. And I can see that anywhere I look, that that is Tai Chi, is the way of all things. And I remember, you know, I remember the beginning of the universe, creation of the planet, everything, all of the things, everything. Everything that I need to know, everything that I need to do. The whole thing unfolded in my mind, constantly being witnessed to me by other people. People were constantly, after that, my whole life became synchronistically linked to the awareness of this being. All the whole world's praying to me, you know, it's like awareness to me. Like, what happens in the media will be all about my life. Chris and Rihanna. You know, fucking, like, all these things, man, you know, just everything. I always feel like somebody's watching me. I can't get no privacy, you know. What happens to you when your name is Chris and you get the face that's on the fucking wall? What do you do? What happens when you get all that, plus your awareness of it's already very strong, you're already mystically inclined, you're Libra. 10-15, 10-15, 10-15, you know, all these things about me, Mormon, brought to the Americas by the Mormon fucking people, for God's sake. What the fuck am I supposed to do? I have to do this. It's the only thing I can do. It's who I am. I'm sorry if you're uncomfortable with it. I guarantee you I have total partitioning that allows me to just pretend like it's not there, even though it is. And I've been holding it in since 99, you know, like, as much as I possibly can. But sooner or later, I had to let it out. And now's the time. It's 2012. The world's gone fucking crazy. People need this more than ever. I have to do it. So, I'm sorry. I'm sorry. I'm sorry. I wish I didn't. I wish I couldn't. I wish I fucking was free from this. But the universe has assured me, with everything that I've seen, that this path is in front of me and it's my destiny and I don't have a choice. So I have to do it. I'm sorry if you don't like it. I'm sorry if it makes you uncomfortable in my presence, or if it fucking ruins our relationship or whatever it is, you know. I'm sorry to everybody. But it has to be done. It has to be done. And I'm willing to sacrifice myself for it, because I have learned the value of poverty, the value of simplicity, and all these other mystical things that nobody else understands. I've done my homework. I've prepared myself for this. I'm a shaman of the highest rank. And my awareness of space and time is beyond anyone else's. What am I supposed to do with that? Sit on it? I can't. So, I'll do this instead. Here I am. I'm going to unfold my dream in front of you. Every day a new video, something else to see. Something, something, something. I'm going to take you through my journey and show you what it was. And maybe when it's all over, I can't go back to work and celebrate along with the rest of you. That is wish I wish. I wish. Come here to me. Help me. We'll take this world. It's mine. The time has come. I have the power to do these things. I know how. I can do it without hurting or doing anything. I don't even have to do anything unrational, you know. Everything is going to be simple. I'll explain it to you in the days coming forward. All right.